Now bring in the members of our jury. So there's an implicit agreement on Survivor, which is nobody is to be trusted, and yet everybody will choose to trust one or more people. It's this implied agreement that makes the blind side possible. So Julie, what's the feeling of being on the right side of a blind side and the wrong side of a blind side?
I definitely was on the wrong side of the blind side the last tribal council, and it is not a good feeling. So I felt like my whole game got turned upside down because I don't trust anyone at this point.
Aurora, what was the fallout from the last tribal? What appeared to be a blindside?
A blindside comes with danger. You have to not bring everyone in because if you do, likely the blindside won't happen. And a lot of these people were people that left out people the time before. So it's not about each move that you're left out. It's the final goal that you want together.
Why the reaction to that, Wardog?
Because it sounded like last week we needed to use a few people to take Eric out, and this week we could maybe take out those same people that we used to take Eric out. So was I just a passenger on their plan, or am I a passenger on our plan?
Wentworth, you were nodding in agreement with that.
Yeah, and I think it's not just what you said, but I think it was the vibe back at camp today. I was trying to establish trust with a group of people. However, the comma group may have gotten back together. So I'm not completely certain what is going to happen tonight.
David, anytime you hear a statement followed by however or but, it means I'm not sure I meant anything I just said.
Yeah, it's a way to give you an answer without blowing up your own game. But this morning in the water, I spotted this huge school of minnows. But eventually a shark came through and ate a bunch of them. And tonight, with the reconstituted comma, it's likely that one of the lessu is a minnow.
Did that really happen?
Yeah. I was taking a poop, but yeah.
Devins, now we have a new analogy, thanks to David. Where are you? You a minnow or a shark?
I might be the poop. At this point, I have no idea what's going on. There are a few people at camp that were the hot date today, which was Gavin and Aurora and Julia and Victoria. And they were gonna get back to us with an answer, and they intentionally let the clock run out.
Wow, Gavin, that is a very bold, honest statement.
Yeah, I mean, it's not as much as I'm avoiding you as everyone breaking off into different groups, and you think you have a set plan, then you meet back up with your group, and oh, well, things have changed.
Julie, I've seen enough tribals to know that trust isn't always what it appears to be. It changes.
It definitely can change quickly because I was feeling pretty good yesterday and I feel like I've hit an all-time low today. Like, I'm physically and mentally drained and I can't do it again.
What's going on?
I don't know. I feel like I look like a lunatic for getting this emotional because it's a game. There are so many other worse things going on in the world, but it's so much harder than I thought because I don't have a clear mind. And then when you feel like you've been left out in the dark of people that you trusted, no matter how much they say you can trust us, I don't think the plan I've been told is happening tonight. I'm sure it's another blindside on the two of us, 100%. So I just feel like if I'm here tomorrow, like, I'm a free agent at this point. Like, I can't trust the people that I've tried to trust all along in this game.
Well, this vote will let Julie and me know if we can trust the people we want to work with. And if all goes as planned, then Julie and I will be in great shape and we will feel so much better.
Two things to address about what you just said. First, one of the great things, Julie, about Survivor being in its 38th season is the people that are fans of this show, they understand this game. There's nobody watching that thinks you're a lunatic because you're exhausted after 20.